Hello student, I am Biraj Singha from Govindpur Shefali Memorial Polytechnic College. Today we will discuss about PLSQL in database management system. PLSQL means programming language or structured query language. At first, PLSQL is a block structure language that enables developer to combine the power of SQL with procedural statement. In a manner, all the statements of a block are passed to Oracle engine all at once, which increases processing speed and decreases the traffic. Disadvantage. What is the disadvantage of SQL? SQL does not provide the programming with a technique of condition checking, looping, and branching. Second disadvantage is SQL statement passed to Oracle engine one at a time, which increases traffic and decreases speed. And third one is SQL has no facility of error checking during manipulation of data. Next is feature of SQL. PLSQL is basically a procedural language. SQL is a procedural language, we all know that, which provides the functionality of decision making, iteration, and many other features of procedural programming language. And PLSQL can execute a number of queries in one block using single command. One can create a PLSQL unit such as procedures, function, package, trigger, etc. and types, which are stored in the database of reuse by application. It can reused in an application. PLSQL provides a feature of to handle the exception which occurs in PLSQL block, known as exception handling block. Next is application written in PLSQL are portable to computer hardware or operating system which Oracle is operational. That is simple. Operating system dependent. And PLSQL offers extensive error checking. Here are the difference between SQL and PLSQL. In previous chapter we will discuss about the what is SQL and basic of SQL and some different types of SQL command. Here some difference between SQL and PLSQL. First, SQL is a single query that is used in perform DML and DDL. DML means data manipulation language and DDL means data definition language. This is the SQL types, DML and DDL. And in PLSQL is a block of codes that used to write the entire program block or procedure or function. Second disadvantage is it is declarative that defines what need to be done rather than how things need to be done. And PLSQL is procedural that defines how to things need to be done. Third one is execute as a single statement and PLSQL execute as a whole block. SQL mainly used to manipulate data and PLSQL used create an application. And SQL cannot contain PLSQL code and PLSQL is an expensive of SQL, so it can be contain SQL statement. PLSQL is extension of SQL statement. Okay. Structure of PLSQL block. Here we see that the structure of PLSQL block. In PLSQL block, there have four things. They are needed four things. First one is declaration part, then begin, then exception, then end part. There are four different part in PLSQL block. Here we see that the type, how we can write First is one is declaration statement here. In begin, they are executable statement. In exception, they are exception handling statement. And last one is end and semicolon. Declare statement start with declare keyword, which in which variable, constant, record or cursor can be declared which stored data temporarily. Here stored data temporarily. It basically consists defines of PL SQL identifier. This part of the code is optional. Then execution section start with begin and end with end keyword. This is a mandatory section, and here the program logic is written to perform any task like loops and conditional statement. All conditional statement are given here within begin and end keyword. And it support DML command, DDL command, SQL plus built-in function, all things. In exception part, exception section start with exception keyword. This section is optional, which constant statement that are execute when a runtime error occurs. Statement that are execute when a runtime error occurs. Then it will working. Any exception can be handled in this section. Any type of exception can be handled in exception section. There are various types of PL SQL identifiers they have, such as variable, constant, procedures, cursor, trigger, etc. The first thing is variable. In C, we also know that C, we know the variable, what is the variable. Here also, variables, same things. Here also we define same things. Like several other programming languages, variable PL SQL must be declared prior to this use. Its use. This should have a valid name, data type as well. Same of C or C++ variable. Syntax for declaration of variable, variable name, first variable name, then data type, that not null equals to what is the value of this variable. And semicolon. Here are one example for different part. First part, then begin part, here begin part, and here end part and exception part. SQL sets superior on SQL declare variable 1 integer, variable 2 real, variable 3 varchar 20. All 3 are variable type. Begin, null and then end. This is a simple example of variable, how variable can write in Oracle. An explanation that what things are here doing in previous example. They are doing set super output on. It is used to display the buffer used by the DBMS output. And variable 1 integer, 3 integer, right? Variable 1 integer, it is the declaration of variable named var1, which is of integer type. There are many other data type that can be used like float, integer, real, small int, long. What about in C? In C, which types of variable we use, data type we use? Here also same data type we used. It also support variable used in SQL as well like number, varchar, varchar 2, it is, varchar 20, it is. Then PL SQL procedure successfully completed. Here you see that. Here the PL SQL procedure successfully completed. Here the execution part perform here. And it is displayed when the code is compiled and executed successfully. Exceptional part. This is the exceptional part. And slash after end. The slash tells the SQL plus of execute the block. That means SQL plus executed the whole block. Here one type of variable. Initializing variables. The variable can also be initialized just like in other programming language. Let us see an example. First, here is an example set. Previous one example set super output on. What is the super output on? Here we discuss about it. It is used to display the buffer used by the DBMS output. It is used buffer used of DBMS output for get DBMS output or DBMS result. Then declare variable 1 integer equals to 2, variable 3 varchar 20 equals to I love gigs for gifts. Then begin null and end, and here are backslash. And now what is the output? Output is PLSQL procedure successfully completed. It is an exceptional part. Okay. Second one is after variable. Second one is displaying output. The output are displayed by using DBMS output. I already tell that display by using DBMS output, which is a built-in package that enables the user to display output, debugging information, and send message from PLSQL block, subcon package, and triggers. Okay, here an example. Same example are here also, and here begin part DBMS output dot putline equals to putline variable. Here we see the output begin DBMS slash output dot put slash line bracket var variable. What variable we can print? We want to print. Okay, then semicolon, then end. And what is the output? Your output is I love gigs for grips. PLSQL procedure successfully completed. Third one is using comments. Like a mandatory other programming language, here also a comment can be put within the code which has no effect in the code. There are two syntax to create comments in PLSQL: single line comment and multi line comment. In C also, we used it hit in single line comment. There also have multi line comment. Here also same. Multi line comment means this. Single line comment means this. The symbol is this. And multi line comment symbol. Here is the multi line comment symbol. Set superior output declare. Here are the single line comment. I am in comment, so I will be ignored. Var varchar 20 in. Okay. Then taking output from user. Just like in other programming language, in PLSQL also we can take input from the user and store it in a variable. And let us see an example. What is the example? Single line comment taking input for a variable a number equals to ampersand of a, and taking input for variable b, where b is variable, variable 2 30 equals to ampersand of b, and begin here null. Here we take null values. Okay, enter and end. Enter the value for a, a is 24, old 2, a number equals to ampersand a, new the key have a 24 that I mean amra niyechi ekhane. Enter value for b, gigs for gigs, that is the variable b variable is a character type of variable. Varchar 20, varchar 20 means character type. Here we give a character, then gigs for gigs, old 3, old 1 3, and b varchar 30 equals to a percent of b, that means gigs for gigs. And let us see an example of PLSQL to demonstrate all above concept in one single block or code. In variable, output, integer, all are in here in an example. Declare here a single line comment taking input for variable a integer equals to ampersand of a. Here also an comment, single line comment, b integer equals to ampersand of b, and c is an integer. And what is the begin? Here is the condition is c equals to a plus b. Simple addition program. DBMS output dot put line, what value he print sum of a and b is equals to c, and end. Okay, this symbol we used sum of a is a variable, we declare in this line, and b is equals to c, and end. What is the result? Enter value for a, that is equals to we enter two values. Example, simple example, two, and value of b equals to 3, and sum of 2 and 3 is 5. Okay. And PLSQL execution environment. The PLSQL engine resides in a Oracle engine. Of course, BL SQL engine resides in Oracle engine. Oracle engine DBMS platform. Okay, the Oracle engine can process not only single SQL statement but also block or many statement. The call to Oracle engine needs to be made only once to execute any number of SQL statement if these SQL statement are bundled inside a PL SQL block. Okay, PL SQL is an extension of SQL. Nothing but this. PL SQL is extension of SQL statement. Okay. Thank you.